Mortal Kombat X, the latest game in the popular and super bloody fighting franchise, has just come out. And while you're polishing your button mashing techniques, we decided to take a quick look at how the top 5 sickest fatalities from the game have been immortalized by actual heroes and villains across both film and television. Number 1 is Liu Kang's deceptively simple but bloody finishing move. Adorably called sore throat, it's guaranteed to leave your enemies, well, speechless. Let's check out the move in all its cheesy and gory detail.
Liu Kang wins. Fatality.
First up, Patrick Swayze, America's all-around heartthrob and general badass, played Dalton, a club bouncer with a goddamn PhD, mind you, haunted by a mysterious past in the 1989 classic Roadhouse. Everything about this film and his role is both painfully and gloriously soaked in pure 80s cliché. Turns out Dalton has a secret love for ripping people's throats out himself. Take a look. Next up, HBO powerhouse show Game of Thrones is definitely known for not shying away from gory violence. Since the 5th season just started, let's pull a vintage scene out and dust it off. Remember Khal Drogo in season 1? Yeah, he might be the new Aquaman, but he'll always be a throat-ripping savage king to us. To round things out, let's move on to another popular television show, AMC's The Walking Dead. To be fair, there are a lot of insane deaths and zombie kills throughout the show's run, but if we have to choose one of our favorites, it's gotta be Rick's take on the whole throat ripping out shtick. I mean, it's bloody, it's raw, and it's just so damn animalistic. Please. Number 2 in our fatality lineup is Kotal Kahn's gruesome skull exploding finisher. Romantically named Keymine, this move obliterates any trace of your enemies ever having a head. Yeah, they won't be coming back for this one.
Kotal Kahn wins. Fatality.
First up, this Game of Thrones scene from last season is still haunting fans from all over the world. The brutality, the gory detail. The fact that we lose a fan favorite character in such a fantastically over-the-top, tooth-explodey fashion. It's all just icing on the cake, really.
Gonna smash their head in like this!
Next up, from one of the most brutally violent and dark movies ever made called Irreversible, comes a scene of violence and skull-crushing that will shake you to your core. You'll see just what it looks like to cave in a man's head with a fire extinguisher. Because you've definitely been wondering about that, right? Last up, the king of torture porn, the Saw series, has an almost endless list of gory and inventive kills in its roster. But this scene from the 4th movie in the franchise is one of the highlights. Detective Rigg finally finds Detective Matthews, but had to violate police protocol to do it. Of course, the new Jigsaw won't stand for that, so punishes him by, well, crushing Matthews' head in a spectacular fashion. Take a look.
Don't open it!
Number 3 in our lineup is Kung Jin's fast and highly effective decapitation fatality. The move called target practice makes for a swift and final end to any fight. Now, decapitation is quite the popular mode of death in many a horror and action film. Needless to say, we found a few classics to enjoy. First up, a classic bloodfest of a movie. I mean, what else would you expect from film master Quentin Tarantino? Kill Bill has plenty of great kills to choose from, but this scene, which starts out quiet but flies by in what feels like a second and sets up what is perhaps one of Lucy Liu's best monologues in her career.
Oh.
Next up is a scene from the French psychological suspense and slasher film, High Tension. Famous horror makeup artist Gianetto De Rossi created all of the special effects, and rest assured the scene will probably give you a few nightmares involving moving furniture. Take a look, you'll see what I'm saying. Last, but by no means least, is horror fan favorite, mass murderer, Jason Voorhees. In the seemingly never-ending series, one decapitation stands out. It's not particularly graphic, but it's pretty damn funny. I mean, how many decapitations do you know of that involve a dumpster? Number 4 in our ultimate ending moves is Quan Chi's bisection finisher. This fatality is gruesome and bloody, and kinda morbidly fascinating. I mean, you get to see your enemies perfectly cut right in half.
Quan Chi wins. Fatality.
First up, even a generally horrible horror movie does at least have a few good and inventive graphic kills to throw at the audience. In this instance, ignore the tacky ghost-seeing glasses and instead focus on the bloody, bisected body of the smarmy lawyer instead. Next, we have 1997's super atmospheric sci-fi flick, Cube. This scene really ups the bisection game. How you might be asking? Freaking lasers, of course. Take a look. Finally, 2002's horror film Ghost Ship wasn't content with having just one person bisected, and well, they can't really copy the whole laser gag thing. Oh no. So, how to kill a whole deck's worth of partying passengers? Well, all in one fell swoop. That's gonna leave a mark. Rounding out our top 5 is Kung Lao's head-splitting saw fatality. This finishing move is blood-splattering and delightfully drawn out. The foot on your victim's back as they stare inches away from the razor-sharp blade on your head, knowing they are completely defeated. Yep, it's pretty much Mortal Kombat's answer to a table saw deck. First up is 1989's horror film Intruder. As an unseen, mysterious killer stalks and dispatches employees at a supermarket after it's closed for the day. Here's a scene with a truly bloody kill, where the victim is brutally aware of the impending doom by blade saw.
No! 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 No!
Next up, American Psycho's Patrick Bateman has a thing for, well, murdering prostitutes. While a lot of the kills in this movie are memorable, this scene is usually the one that really sticks with you. A prostitute, having discovered several dead bodies in Patrick's apartment, attempts to flee. She gets as far as the stairs before Patrick catches up to her. Well, it's, I guess, more the chainsaw he drops on her that catches up to her, but you get the point. Finally, a gory and terrifying French film, Frontiers, about a young female thief and her gang who encounter a family of awfully sadistic neo-Nazis. They quickly realize they have to fight back to have any chance of survival. The crazy premise sets up this great scene, where young Yasmin finally saws a Nazi's head, well, wide open.
Stand back!